Emails from Jihadi John, Mohammed Amwazi. I'm like a dead man walking, fearing that one day I will take as many pills as I can so I can go to sleep forever. Sent to a British journalist in December 2010, published this weekend in the UK's Daily Mail newspaper. In the email, Amwazi tells journalist Robert Vercake that he wants to sell his laptop, that he brings it to the station here to meet a buyer. The buyer pays for it with cash without even checking it out, and then says to him, "Nice doing business with you, Mohammed." Amwazi says he never told the buyer his first name and immediately decided the buyer must have been working for British intelligence. Islamist activist group Cage also released a slew of emails, it says, are from Amwazi. They too paint a picture of a man hounded by British intelligence. This is an account of questioning by security officials in June 2010. He grabbed onto my T-shirt and threw me onto the wall. All this was happening to me while the officers sat down casually, not stopping or doing anything. I was having difficulty breathing. He finally let go of my neck. According to Cage's emails, dating to June 2010, Amwazi's problems began on a safari trip to Tanzania in 2009, when British intelligence first questioned him.
You know, we should be very clear. I mean, that's not where the story begins. There are reports of his people who went to school with him that are saying that he was not just very anti-Israeli, but actually anti-Semitic. He was very anti-Jewish. So there are signs there that actually he had some more radical and extreme perspectives well before any engagement with the authorities.
Rashad Ali works countering radical narratives, says Amwazi had ties to the failed July 21st, 2005 bombings in London, just one of several worrying jihadi links.
There are phone call connections with those individuals even on the day of the attack. Would have been the first sign that they would be interested, but also more than that, that he was traveling with people who wanted to go and join Al-Shabaab. That was what the intelligence said, and that's what actually proved to be true afterwards.
That's Al-Shabaab, the Al-Qaeda affiliate in Somalia.
Court documents quoted in the British media indicate UK officials believed Amwazi was part of a group of radical Islamists known as the North London Boys. They were providing funding and equipment for the Al-Qaeda fledgling group in Somalia. That he was also, according to the British media, part of a criminal gang robbing the wealthy residents here in West London.
Amwazi, not the innocent victim his and Cage's emails seek to portray. Nick Robertson, CNN, London.